Hi, everyone. I'm Jeffrey Goldberg, the editor-in-chief of The Atlantic, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the first, and if things go well in America and the world, last all-digital Atlantic Festival. I'd like to thank my friend John Batiste, who is The Atlantic's music director, he also has other jobs, I believe, for providing that amazing rendition of the battle hymn for our opening. For those of you who don't know The Atlantic, our magazine was founded 163 years ago to be, among other things, the town square for debate and illumination of the American idea. The founders, including such giants as Longfellow, Ralph Waldo Emerson, Harriet Beecher Stowe, Herman Melville, and Oliver Wendell Holmes, didn't define for future generations the American idea. That's the work of each new generation of Atlantic journalists. What we believe in this moment of high tension and national fracturing is that we should be helping America understand itself, its role in the world, and its future as a multicultural democracy. Our magazine was home to some of the greatest writers in American history: Frederick Douglass, Mark Twain, Ernest Hemingway, Helen Keller, W.E.B. Du Bois, Virginia Woolf, and many, many more. And we try to carry on the tradition today. At our best, we hold the powerful accountable and provide our readers, through great reporting, writing, and thinking, with new ways to make sense of the world. And we give them great stories as well. We're here today and over the next few days to explore this very strange year and to try to figure out with our newsmaking guests where we're headed. There's a lot on the plate. We're struggling through the pandemic, and we continue to deal with a society-wide racial reckoning and a set of unique challenges to our democratic way of life. The current issue of our magazine is focused on some core questions about America's identity and purpose. We call that issue the Making America Again issue. The festival carries that mission to our virtual stage. This week, we'll hear from some of the most influential leaders in politics, business, media, and culture as we explore what it will take to build a more perfect union. I hope you will enjoy the conversations this week. To start us off, late last week, I spoke with Apple CEO Tim Cook.